Hello, this is Eric Bolt from the National Weather Service in Oxnard, California. Here's a quick update on the El Nino Southern Oscillation status and rainfall predictions for the upcoming 2014 and 15 winter season across Southwest California. While we continue to be in an El Nino watch, let's not forget that until we see substantial widespread rainfall, the threat of large wildfires in Southwest California is very high. November is a peak month for Santa Ana's, and fuel moistures are at all-time minimum values due to climatology and the ongoing drought. In the latest ENSO information, the ocean is reflecting weak El Nino conditions, but we're still waiting for the atmosphere to sync up. A full-fledged El Nino is not expected until December, if at all. And just a reminder that you can find monthly updates to the El Nino conditions at the following website. Here is a reminder that during the El Nino cycle, the warmer subtropical Pacific Ocean helps fuel an elongated jet stream, bringing moist storm systems across the southern sections of the country. Typically, wetter conditions occur across the southern states, while drier and warmer weather impacts the northern states during an El Nino. The latest sea surface temperature anomalies across the subtropical Pacific Ocean. The left side of the chart shows the cooler temperatures last year at this time, while current time is on the far right. All Niño regions are warmer than normal right now, with the Niño 3.4 box at 0.6 degrees Celsius. This is the main region for determining El Niño conditions. This is slightly higher than the minimal 0.5 degrees threshold for a weak El Niño. A consensus prediction between scientists at the Climate Prediction Center and the International Research Institute at Columbia University has decreased in the past month, from a high of 65% down to a current 58% chance of El Nino developing this winter. The latest ENSO plume computer forecasts continue to show most model outcomes keep us in a neutral ENSO, or weak El Nino, condition this winter. This is a snapshot of annual rainfall in the Santa Barbara area during El Nino and La Nina years going back to 1950. Weak El Nino events have seen large extremes, as shown by the black arrows. For example, in 2007, Santa Barbara received around 6 inches of rain, while in 2005, over 36 inches occurred. Normal rainfall is around 18.5 inches. The official long-term temperature prediction for the month of November shows above normal for the entire western United States. Precipitation for November shows no significant trend for California, and we are already trending drier than normal. The temperature predictions for our main rainy season of January through March shows above normal temperatures continuing for the west coast. And the precipitation predictions for the same time frame does show a higher chance of above normal precipitation over Southwest California. This forecast follows a classic El Nino trend of wetter storm systems across Southern California compared to the northern part of the state. In conclusion, it's still uncertain if a full-fledged El Nino will develop, and we're running out of time. When an El Nino occurs, the chances of above normal rainfall are better than other years for Southern California. Historically, weak El Niños have resulted in very large extremes, either wet or dry. Thank you for watching this presentation. If you have any comments or questions, please contact me. And remember to visit our website for the latest forecast, watches, or warnings.